Evening. Welcome to the warm and inviting sanctuary of Third Presbyterian Church. I am Conley Zomerman, interim pastor of Third Church, and I am honored and privileged to greet you tonight. I travel from church to church by design in my ministry. Not all congregations, lovely though they may be, are created musically equal. The Rochester community and Third Church share a great musical history and an abundance of talent. As a singer myself, I rejoice in being able to contribute a little to the delightful mix here. But mostly, like all of you, I simply enjoy it. We thank all the musicians for sharing their gifts with us this evening. One program note, baritone David Wolfe is not able to sing with us tonight. Again, I say, welcome. Enjoy our musical offerings to warm you this November-ish November evening.
Good evening. You just heard Jonathan Dove's The Dancing Pipes, a piece only composed 6 years ago for St. Lawrence Church, Ludlow, England, just outside of Hereford. And it was written for the 250th anniversary of their organ. Perhaps a deep contrast between what would have been written that back then and this piece from 2014. The piece was commissioned for and by Thomas Trotter, a well-known, formidable English concert organist, who I believe actually played this piece on this organ here at Third Church some years ago when giving a concert. Dove writes, and you'll have heard, that when composing this piece, this recurring dance-like motif kept kind of injecting into his brain and pervades the piece throughout. It appears more and more in different ways, and even at the end, when you think you've got to the end, that small motif just comes back on the small flutes of the organ. It's now my great pleasure to welcome our soprano choral scholar, Heather Holmquist.
Good evening, everyone. I have three pieces to offer you tonight. The first by George Frederick Handel, and the next two by Florence Price. Handel's aria, Va Godendo, is taken from his opera, Xerxes, of which you might be familiar with the very first aria of that entire opera, which is Ombra Mai Fu, or better known as the Largo. This aria is in fact a response to that aria, in which upon hearing Xerxes praise trees, specifically one tree in particular, she gently mocks him with this aria, praising effusively the brook that runs through the kingdom. The next two pieces, like I said, are by Florence Price. Florence Price was born in 1887 in Arkansas and died in 1953 in my home city of Chicago. She was the first black female composer to ever have a symphony played by a major symphony orchestra in Chicago. And this symphony number one in E minor should have been a launch into a successful career, but as she was black and as she was female, in a very white male composer world, every single success was met and overcome with struggles. Nevertheless, her songs, piano works, and many, many other pieces were published in Chicago, and she made connections with fellow composer Margaret Bonds and soprano Marian Anderson, two black artists and wonderful in their own right. And because of these connections, her name was sort of continued on through in the musical sort of collective unconscious. And I'm very happy that in the last few years, her music has been revitalized and has been performed much more often, as is her due, because her music is fantastic. So I'm happy to share two of her songs with you tonight. The first, called Night, is a chromatically luscious piece that's this late romantic sweeping gestures. The story is a night personified as a mother figure who lights her lamp, the moon, over the daytime, which is depicted in this poem as a sleepy child. And then the second song, last song I'll sing for you, is Out of the South Blew a Wind, which is a gracious nod to the Tin Pan Alley Americana songs of the early 1900s. And I love in particular the sweeping whole tone scale that Peter will play underneath the word wind, that I just hear as the sort of southern wind that blew Florence Price from Arkansas up to Chicago to flourish in my hometown. So I hope you enjoy these.
Vento, vento, joy, vento. Good evening. My name is Stephen Bigner, and I'm going to be performing two pieces tonight. The first piece is Nigra Sum from Monteverdi's Vespers of 1610. This piece is something that I learned sort of late in my education, but the first time that I heard it, it was unlike anything that I had ever heard, from its incredible just minute and a half, 2 minutes of D major. In the very beginning, all the vocal and instrumental pyrotechnics throughout the piece, and then the glorious Magnificat at the end. And it became a very special piece to me. It sort of cracked open this world of early music that I didn't know existed, and in a certain way led me to meet my wife. And this piece became a very important piece for us as well. And in fact, my wife walked down the aisle to the opening of Monteverdi's Vespers. So that was delightful. The next piece that I'm going to be performing is a few centuries later by Franz Schubert. It's Wandres Nachtlied 2. It's the second setting of the piece that he did, which is fitting because the story goes that Goethe wrote this short little four-line poem and actually carved it into the door or the wall of this little cabin out in the woods. And then several decades later, he went back as a much older man to the same cabin and found his original poem sort of fading away. And he reread it and went back and carved it in even deeper. And there's just something about this piece that's always spoken to me, that story. And the very last line of the text is, "Wart nur balde, ruhest du auch." Which basically is, wait, soon you too shall rest.
Et dixit me.
Next up is a piece that Pete and I will play as an organ and piano duet, which is something that organists very rarely get to do, so I'm grateful for the chance. César Franck was a Parisian organist, notably at Saint-Clotilde, and his prelude, fugue, and variation is the third of his six pieces dedicated to Camille Saint-Saëns. The piece is normally heard as an organ solo, although it was originally conceived for piano and harmonium. Tonight, you'll hear organ and piano. The melody of the prelude is simple, elegant, pensive, and basically moves by stepwise motion, under which there is a perpetual current of eighth notes provided by the piano. A stately fugue follows, drawing out each note until its eventual climax before the original melody returns, this time with continuous running 16th notes underneath.
Thank you. Hello and good evening. My name is Joshua Shepherd, and it's a privilege to perform for you tonight. James and I will be performing two selections by Mozart. The first is Se vuol ballare from Le nozze di Figaro. In this opera, I, Figaro, am engaged to marry the most beautiful woman in all the world, Susanna. But my plans to marry her are going to be foiled by the Count, who intends to lie with Susanna before the wedding. I feel very betrayed and hurt by this decision of the Count because I have been a long friend of his, and Susanna and I are actually both his servants. However, I, hearing this information, sing in this aria, Se vuol ballare, signor continuo, il chitarrino le suonerò, which means, if you want to dance, I will play the music on my guitar, as if to say, two can play at that game. Of course, Susanna and the Count's wife, the Contessa, are the ones who actually come up with the plan that thwarts him. It seems in this opera that the women are always one step ahead of their male counterparts, which is fitting. The second piece which we'll be performing is An Chloe, also by Mozart. In this piece, I am singing to Chloe about how wonderful and how much I love her. I sing of her bright, beautiful eyes, her rosy cheeks, how we will sit together, how I will hold her tightly, and of course, how all this love makes me exhausted. I hope you enjoy.
Yeah. Good evening. It is so good to be here with you all, even if it's virtually tonight. My name's Andrew McGall, and tonight James and I will be presenting three short art songs all about flowers. The first song is a French song by French composer Gabriel Fauré, and its title is Green, which, as you can imagine, is about all the beautiful green things in nature that evoke feelings of passion and beauty, similar to those feelings that love also produces too. The second song is a Norwegian song that I discovered this summer, and it's a beautiful song that I hold dear to my heart. Shout out to my Norwegian relatives that might be watching today. And this song is called Pinselilia, or Pentecost flower, or sometimes known as a daffodil. And this song describes how that flower, white flower, blooms so beautifully but fades away too soon in its prime. And the last song is by American composer Charles Ives, called Two Little Flowers. And Charles Ives wrote both the music and the text to this song, so listen carefully for which two flowers are his favorite in his backyard.
Voici des fruits, des fleurs, des feuilles et des branches. Éprouvez vos sentiments qui vous manquent pour vous. Ne déchirez les mains avec votre main blanche.
On sunny days. Last month, we celebrated the 150th anniversary of the birth of Louis Vierne, the great French organist and composer of the late 19th and early 20th centuries. He had a very difficult life. From birth, he was nearly blind, and that continued through his life. He also had a number of other emotional and physical difficulties, including a very painful divorce, losing his brother and son to World War I, and so a number of other difficulties, but also he had a number of high points as well, primarily being appointed titular organist at Notre Dame in Paris in 1900, a post that he held until his death in 1937. In his early years, he studied with César Franck and Charles-Marie Vidor, two giants of French organ music, and he took different aspects from each of them, a very lyrical and passionate side from the music of Franck, and a very clear sense of structure and discipline from Vidor. And he synthesized these into his own style and continued the development of the organ symphony, which was a new genre that was really had its roots in the music of Franck. He composed six symphonies in the course of his life, and among other organ works. But the piece that I'll play, the chorale, is the second movement of the second symphony, composed in 1902, not long after he took the post at Notre Dame. And in some ways, I know there isn't a program to this music or a story behind it, but in some ways it kind of encapsulates the various aspects of Vierne's life for me. There's a lovely, serene, hymn-like chorale tune that begins the movement, only to be overshadowed by some ominous, turbulent music underneath that comes back to that very calm, hymn-like tune a couple of more times. But it ends, as it builds, it brings those two aspects together in a very triumphant finale.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us for this little musical soiree this evening. I hope you've enjoyed it. And I would invite you to come back to our YouTube channel next Friday, or not to our YouTube channel, but for our next event, next Friday evening at 7:30. It's a group of 5 Eastman organ students, all of whom were semi-finalists in the National Young Artist Competition in Organ Performance of the American Guild of Organists that was supposed to happen last summer. They weren't able to hold that competition, so we've invited 5 of the students, all from the studio of David Higgs at the Eastman School, to present the Eastman 5 concert next week. This instrument will be featured along with several others in the community. That can be found on the Rochester AGO website, rocago.org, and it will be streamed from that site next Friday evening at 7:30. And then in December, on Sunday the 13th at 3 p.m., invite you back to our YouTube channel for another concert of Christmas and Advent, sort of pops-ish as well as sacred music presented by James, me, and our wonderful choral scholars again. So I'd like to invite everyone to come back up and say a final thank you to everyone, and thank you to all of my wonderful colleagues for a great evening.